We have to put them on sale too. Next. All those candies that are gummy and all those red colors that you see on any candies or things that you eat. Next. So now, this is me teaching them. Then I say, now, what can we do? It could be as simple and inexpensive as changing your diet. That's it. Next, please. And to change the diet is going back to the beginning. Go ahead. When God created man in his own image, in the image of God created he him. Male and female created he, then Genesis 2:27. Next. Remember that I have some friends here from some of the classes, and they know that verse, we always talk about it. God said, I have given you every seed-bearing plant that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed it is, fruit to you they shall be for food. That's in Genesis, something 29. Okay, the names. I have some pictures over there. It is very clear over there, but it's not clear over here. But that was at the graduation.
Jim
one
has
time.
The controls. Oh, turn the light. Hit the light switch.
Let's see if we can see it a little bit better. Yes. Out of the people over there, I think I have two of them here. Okay, visiting today. The next, please. That was a time that they were waiting for something, so everybody was on the talking. Go ahead. Next. And that was the graduation of that class. Everyone was bringing a dish that they learned how to make in the class. So they brought them over and we shared with everybody. So that's what we did for graduation that time. Next. And that was all the food that we have that night over there. Now, don't ask me why I'm vegan. Ask yourself why you are not. Okay?
We thought it'd be nice if she would share the book that has the recipes and information that each student gets.
Yes, every class I made a different book with different designs and everything. And the theme is theme is different for every class. And as the week come by, every week I give them the sheets for every one of the classes. I don't give it all together because then they go and don't listen anymore and don't come back.
Now I've asked Alida to have a couple of her students come forward and maybe share their thoughts on the class.
Yes.
Just say how you feel about taking the classes.
Hi, I'm Cecilia, and I was totally in awe of the classes. Besides learning new things, because being a vegetarian was definitely not in my vocabulary, it really opened my eyes up to how to cook differently. I'm not practicing it completely, but I'm working on it. It's a learning process, and I've come to three classes, and I'm still learning. And Alida is such a blessing because she just ministers the word of God to people that might not ordinarily listen to it or hear it in a different way. And it was a big blessing to me, and I'm so grateful to have met Alida and to come to this little fellowship. This is a really dear place to be.
Yes, I do. You know, I was the type of person that would buy 20 frozen dinners and shove them in the freezer, and that's how I ate. And then I could read recipes, but when it would say, chop this or chop that, is it little teeny chops or is it bigger chops? I had no idea. And then I took my first class here, my first vegan class. And Alita is a wonderful teacher. I mean, she does things in stages and then walks around and shows the whole class what it looks like. And that has helped me so much.
Uh-huh.
And everything that we eat is so delicious. Yeah. If you haven't taken a class, when the next one comes up, you best be there. Thank you.
The girls just explained very well exactly about the class. Some of your members are come to the class, and Scotty invited me, and I thought, well, okay, then I'll go. And then when you walk in, you smell the aroma, and then your mouth does start watering. And then, as they said, Alita goes to each step, so there's, and then she gives us the ingredients, and she shows us the products, you know, from the ground meal, and then she tells us about the bad things, the bones. And then we eat, and then you hear, oh, God, this is so good. And you wouldn't think, because I like meat. And we had some products, and she shows us how to form it so it looks like, so we don't feel deprived. And when we taste it, it's like, oh my goodness, this tastes like meat. This is so good. And I was really, really shocked. And so I went through my second class. And Alita is a great instructor. She does explain things. And so I'm very blessed to have went. And she gives us scripture. And she sprinkles it all with the Word of God.
Uh-huh.
And so it is, it's a blessing to go. So I'm looking forward to next time to seeing you, new you.
So I have a little secret to share. And I know it's been hard for my husband for 14 years, but I'm going to finally admit that I really didn't know how to cook. It was just terrible. It was embarrassing. And I just, you know, I've been saying, I know how to cook, and I had no clue. And so Alita's class has really been life-changing. And what's nice is when I came in, I was a little nervous and scared and timid to come in, and everyone was so warm and welcoming, and I really made lifelong friends in the class. And it is true. Alita does an amazing job of dumbing it down. I'll say that very nice for people like, I don't know, me. But she really does takes her time, shows you exactly what ingredients to use, how to do it. And you get to eat the meal and enjoy it with friends, and it really is life changing. So I really do appreciate it.
Okay, one last question, Alita. What is your favorite Bible text?
It's so hard for me to do what I'm doing because it is not my language. And if that was in Spanish, I would just be jumping around and talking that you couldn't stop me. But it's in English, and my verse is Philippians 4:13. Todo lo puedo en Cristo que me fortalece. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me.
Amen. Thank you, Alita. Thank you so much, Alita, for sharing with us what you do. You're a dedicated servant of God, and it shows by how hard you work in creating a successful cooking class. And thank you to each one of your students who were willing to share with us this morning your testimonies. Now, I'm just going to
ask how many people raise their hand to get into her class.
Well, how many of us in this room have been to her class? Quite a few. Good. So we'll look forward to seeing you next time. Now, we live in a sinful world. We're going to need this light off up here. There's sickness, pain, just this light. There's sickness, pain, sorrow, and death, sometimes no matter how healthy your lifestyle is. I've heard it said more than once, look at so-and-so. He lived till he was 102, he ate meat, he ate whatever he wanted, and drank of whatever every day, never sick a day in his life. And I've also heard, look at so-and-so. She was a vegan. She never smoked or drank. She exercised daily. She got cancer and died before she was 50 years old. The fact is, this is a sinful world we live in. Sin is destroying our bodies and our earth. But as Christians, we know this is not the end.
Amen.
We have hope. And we are here to share that hope with others. Let's invite the Holy Spirit to live in our hearts and bodies. Let's ask God to help us do our very best to present our bodies in the best healthy way we can, so that others will see that God does change lives, that God has a better plan. There will still be diseases and death, but you know what? This world is not our home. It's only temporary. Let's welcome him into our lives. Let's encourage each other and pray for each other on our journeys, because it's not easy. Soon Jesus will come and take us to heaven. We will be made whole and perfect and live forever with our Creator and our Savior. Let's bow our heads for a little word of prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for being our Savior. Thank you for the promise of eternal life with you. Please give us the strength and courage to live for you here, where you've put us, to share your love with others. We ask your presence in our lives now, and we ask that you help us to do our best to present to you our bodies as your temple. Thank you for your presence with us this morning. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.